All right, guys, we're back. We ain't done nothing on this little truck in a little while. But what I've been thinking about these fuel lines, I don't like it. And things run right on up there by the headers. How y'all can see it, but anyway, it runs that, and the battery cables all run right on down the chassis. Then it runs right on up top, down and around. And comes back here to the fuel pump. Braided hose out of the pump, out of the fuel cell to the pump. I don't like it though. Copper tubing that I used, I don't like it. So, I got another batch of braided hose, 6AN braided hose. And I think what I'm gonna do, I just got it draped over there now. I think what I'm gonna do is run it down up inside the chassis here, up on the outside, around the body support. And then we'll strap it up high to the chassis. Yeah, there you are, up high to the chassis, right on down. Come around. I think it'll come on up there to the where the regulator's sitting right up there. May move the regulator over and make a new piece to go to the carburetor. I'm not sure yet. But I'll get that run, get that old line tore out, and I'll get back with you guys here in just a minute. All right, guys, let's see if we can't get this stuff busted out. Bit extension. I have two bit extensions. Let's see, guys, I got one more. We'll probably have to take out the ratchet. It's the daggone close. Thank you. be stuck then. I got one that's going to fight me. Have a shallow socket for that one. Let's raise y'all a bit. Well, okay. Got that one. Get that. Tubing cutter and cut that one right there. And cut it right up here. Yeah, this whole deal, I just ain't real happy with the fuel line running so close to the exhaust, right on down the truck. I mean, it's going to make the fuel get hot, and hot fuel's not real good. Hot fuel don't make power, so I'm gonna get rid of it. Move it around the outside of the frame. And that'll put me a heat shield. Come on now. There it goes. There goes gas. Go back there to the back. See what it's going to take. Let's see. I'll grab a wrench. All right, guys. Let's go for a walk. I'm going to take that line. I cut this line off right here. Drain the cell for put this electric pump in, so whatever line of gas is in here should be just in that line. Okay. Put this wrench in. Tubing cutters and cut that ferrule, flat ferrule off of it. To be able to get it out. That's all. But there's the fuel line laying in the floor. This is a piece of hat on testing to turn off the regulator. In it with a couple of straps, and we'll hold it in a bit to see a little better. screw and a welder. But anyway, let's put a couple more just to hold it. And all I'm using, guys, right now is just some, I'm gonna get some PVC coated straps. But it's a half inch EMT one hole strap for now, just to hold it. But I'm gonna get some PVC or rubber coated, whatever you call them, one hole strap. But this will hold it for now. Yeah, to give y'all kind of an idea. Of what my idea is. Come back here. That's what lift arms are good for. Hold the crap above your head, and before you know it, you're knocking it down on your head. Oh boy, it's gonna be one of them days. Be one of them days, I believe. Just not going to let me get in there like I want to. So. And I'm trying to. Might have to drill it. Bit here. Let's see if we can't make something happen. Not with that bit. Well, that one either. Invest in some drill bits. Well, I'm not gonna try this for about one more time. ain't worth 2 cents. Try one more. It won't tighten up in the chuck for some reason. Maybe that done it. Cute. Alright guys, that's kind of what I had in mind. If, you know, you guys think I need to do something different, then let me know. But I'm gonna get y'all adjusted here, like maybe here in a minute. Uh-oh, I'm about to lose you. But anyway, that's yeah, it'll have one strap right in there. And then that thing kind of come around. Got to go around them battery cables. I'll tell you what, it's easier this way. It'll do something of that sort. Go around those battery cables right there and then strap up to the inside of the frame rail, run up over top of the brake lines back there, and come on, focus up, over top of the coilover shock, come down. And my filter is going to be mounted right back here, probably right here. It'll go in the filter, out the filter, in the pump, out. But that's kind of the plan right now. Anyway, see if I can get some of this strapped up and I'll get back with you boys. I'll be back. Sitting here idling now. right, guys. I don't think it gets much better than that, starting to run anyway. They need to tweak on that carburetor a little bit, but not much. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna get my, I got a new inline filter coming, should be here in the next few days, maybe. And we're gonna get ready to put this thing on the road. All right, I'll check you guys later. See ya. They need to tweak on that carburetor a little bit, but not much. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna get my, I got a new inline filter coming, should be here in the next few days, maybe. And we're gonna get ready to put this thing on the road. All right, I'll check you guys later. See you.